Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Inflammation, a chapter of pathology for both BDS and BAMS. And the topics we'll be discussing today are acute inflammation, major components of acute inflammation, and mediators of acute inflammation. So the first thing to be wondered about is, what is acute inflammation? So as we have discussed in our previous videos, what is inflammation? It is a response of our body towards offending agents, so to eliminate them. So acute inflammation is a kind of inflammation only, but the kind of inflammation which persists for a shorter time. Because acute means its literal meaning is shorter. So acute inflammation is an inflammation which lasts for a shorter duration as compared to chronic inflammation which persists for a longer duration of time. So always go with the literal meaning. Acute means shorter. So it persists for a shorter duration of time and also have different mediators as compared to chronic inflammation. Now let's move on to the major components of acute inflammation. That means wo major steps jo acute inflammation mein hote hain, which leads to elimination of the offending agent. So the very first step after our tissue macrophages identifies the offending agent, which is either microbes or tissue injury. सबसे पहले क्या होता है, हमारी जो ब्लड वेसल्स हैं जितनी भी वो डायलेट होती हैं ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस एंड देयर इज अ स्पेसिफिक ऑर्डर कि उनका डायलेशन कैसे होता है. फर्स्ट आर्टीरियोल्स आर डायलेटेड एंड देन कैपिलरीज आर डायलेटेड. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर द ऑर्डर बिकॉज इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. पहले वेजो डायलेशन होगा आर्टीरियोल्स का एंड देन ऑफ कैपिलरीज. And this dilation, vasodilation, takes place in the presence of mediators. Then comes the step second, which is increased permeability of these vessels. Pehle ye vasodilate hongi, vaso means vascular and dilation means to increase in size. Then increased permeability is the immediate second step which follows. अब परमिएबिलिटी इंक्रीज होती है वेन्यूज की. सो वी हैव ऑल द थ्री, आर्टीरियल्स और कैपिलरीज का डायलेशन एंड देन परमिएबिलिटी इंक्रीज होती है वेन्यूज की, ताकि जो प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स हैं और जो ल्यूकोसाइट्स हैं वो सर्कुलेशन से बाहर आए टुवर्ड्स द टिश्यू एंड एलिमिनेट देम. देन द थर्ड स्टेप इज कि अब जो है जो ल्यूकोसाइट्स और प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स माइक्रोवास्कुलेचर से बाहर आ गए हैं, नाउ दे आर फाइनली अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स द साइट जहाँ पे एक्चुअली माइक्रोब्स या इंजूरियस एजेंट है. सो द थर्ड स्टेप इज एमिग्रेशन ऑफ ल्यूकोसाइट्स एंड प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन्स टुवर्ड्स द साइट ऑफ इंजरी और टुवर्ड्स द साइट वेयर माइक्रोब्स और बैक्टीरिया वायरसेस हैव एग्जैक्टली infected. Now after leukocyte 1 emigrate from that particular microvasculature towards that particular site, the next step is activation of leukocytes. Finally leukocytes activate them because हमारी जो microvasculature है उसमें ऐसा तो है नहीं कि leukocytes हमेशा ही कुछ ना कुछ phagocytose करने के mood में रहती है. It's not like that. So once leukocyte emigrate, their accumulation and their activation at the site of infection is necessary. Without activation, this whole procedure of phagocytosis and this whole procedure of inflammation is just a waste. Once leukocytes are activated with the help of various mediators, jo hum padhenge aage, then the last step is phagocytosis. Finally, what leukocytes do is they are activated and then they phagocytose the respective microbe or the injurious agent like sutures, dirt, etc. And after phagocytosis, the whole purpose of inflammation is solved. So activation and phagocytosis, they are important. Now in this diagram, you can see all the steps of this inflammation, acute inflammation, collectively. You can see when microbes or necrotic tissue are present, the macrophage tissue identifies them, release some mediators which causes vasodilation. Once vasodilation is caused, increased permeability is being seen, and then recruitment of leukocytes. After recruitment of leukocytes, there is edema, and after edema, leukocytes actually collect at their place of focus of injury. Then what do? They are activated to kill that microbe, and then after that they phagocytose that microbe. And once all that is done, there is the need of tissue repair, because is sabhi process mein jitna bhi process jo microbe ka killing ka process hai, isme of course si baat hai jo usual normal human tissue hai wo bhi damage hota hai, because as we know ki jung pe jayenge to sena ke jo sainik hai wo to shaheed honge. So last step is tissue repair after phagocytosis is done. And this all takes place in the presence of mediators. Here in the diagram, you can see various mediators like histamine, cytokines, TNF, interleukin 1, etc. So these cytokines and these mediators, they are discussed in the coming slides. And of course, in the coming videos, jisme hum har jo hai mediator in depth discuss karenge. Also, you can see here that fibroblast also has a role in tissue repair, which we will be discussing. Now, before moving forward, let's look at what are the different mediators and what do we understand by mediators of inflammation. So, mediators of inflammation, wo substances hain jo ki har reaction ko convey karti hai. Like jaise injury ho rahi hai, to they identify the substance and they convey the message. So these are basically certain chemicals or plasma proteins, and their function is to convey the message from one thing to other. Like macrophages, agar koi chemokine secrete kare, so their function is to convey. Also, in technical terms, we can say that they are responsible to initiate and regulate the inflammatory reaction. Without them, it would not be possible to initiate or regulate the inflammatory reaction. Now we will see a list of various mediators on our screen. There are various mediators and they are based on their chemistry as well. Like we have vasoactive amines. So vasoactive amines are known so because they are amines. And we have two examples in that. That is histamine and the other is serotonin. Histamine is the vasodilator and serotonin is the vasoconstrictor. We will be looking forward in all the reactions. So it is very important to remember the function of particular mediator, because then only we can write it in the reaction and then only we can relate it. Now, after vasoactive amine, we have arachidonic acid metabolites. Hamari body mein ek fatty acid hoti hai, that is arachidonic acid. And often arachidonic acid ka metabolism se hume do important mediator milte hain. One is prostaglandin, which jiske bare mein thoda bahut hume pehle se pata hai that it is responsible for pain during inflammation. And the other is leukotriene. Apart from prostaglandin and leukotriene, arachidonic acid also produces a metabolite known as lipoxin, jiska function hota hai inflammation ko control karna. Prostaglandin and leukotriene initiates inflammation and lipoxins are responsible to control that inflammation taki wo further increase hoke damage na kare. Now third is cytokines. We have two important cytokines, TNF and the other is interleukin. TNF stands for tissue necrotic factor and interleukin is also represented by IL. आप लोगों ने कई बार सुना होगा IL-1, IL-2, तो those are nothing but mediators of inflammation, and those are cytokines. Then we have various chemokines, which will be discussed in depth in chemokines. After that, the fourth mediator is complement system, which is a group of various mediators we will be looking at. Then we have platelet factors, which are released from platelets, as the name suggests. Then we have coagulation factors, those factors which help in coagulation, blood coagulation, but also aid in inflammation. Then we have kinins on the seventh number. Kinin ka ek example aap logo ne sun rakha hoga, that is bradykinin. So bradykinin is just like histamine only, but is different in chemical nature. So it is included in kinin, and iska function bhi to a certain extent vasodilation hi hota hai. Of course, it has got many other functions, but one of the major functions is this. Then we have neuropeptides, which are proteins. As the name suggests, peptide वहाँ पे आता है जहाँ पे protein involved होता है. So neuropeptides are proteins involved in this mediation of inflammation. So we have seen many chemical mediators and will be seeing forward to depth of these mediators. Thank you. Like, share and subscribe if you like the video.